Let's say we have a two-dimensional plane and two classes of objects, and we want to put a border between them. We can change the width of the border, or we can play with the orientation. Our goal is to find the border as wide as possible and keep the objects separated. Let's do an example for only two objects, but some background. First, a hyperplane can be represented by a normal vector w and a scalar b. The normal vector determines the orientation. The bias, on the other hand, controls the displacement from the origin. The margin I mentioned before can be described by using two hyperplanes. By changing the angle of the normal vector, we can rotate the margin, or if you want to shift, you can increase or decrease the bias. It's an easy exercise to show that the width of the margin is 2 divided by the length of the normal vector. This means that the width is reversely proportional to the length of the normal vector. Now it's time for notations. We denote the coordinates with x1 and x2. And we use y1 and y2 to describe the labels. We are using plus and minus 1 for the labels, and this is a crucial step in the algorithm. Let's construct the optimization problem. We want to maximize the width of the margin, which means the length of the normal vector should be minimized. To get rid of the square roots, we square the norm. What about the constraints? Well, we have two constraints. First, the plus class object should be above the border, and the minus class object should be below the border. If we multiply the constraints with their class labels, the inequalities become very similar and easy to work with. At the end, we reach this optimization problem. To solve it, we multiply the inequalities with Lagrange multipliers to create the primal dual form. Karışkan-Tucker conditions for this form is as follows. The partial derivatives with respect to the normal vector and bias is 0. Lagrange multipliers alpha are non-negative, and the multiplication of alpha with the inequalities are 0. If we take the derivatives and plug them into the primal dual form, we get the dual form. If we put the knowns into the dual form, we get a very simple polynomial from which the optimum Lagrange multipliers alpha 1 and alpha 2 are determined. Then we can go back to find the normal vector w. To determine the bias, we need to use the non-zero Lagrange multipliers. In our case, for each one, b turns out to be 0. To summarize, for the objects shown here, we found the largest margin by solving an optimization problem. If you want to see more examples, please let me know by writing your comments down below. Thank you.